Vancouver Culture Society in New York and also represent Foundation for Human Horizon. So I welcome all of you on the board of organizations who the people work behind the in the organizations and behind the scene and everybody supported. So I am very very thankful. Thank you to you all for coming over here to celebrate Baba Saab's 126th birth anniversary in the consulate. And yesterday was a great great event in the United Nations. I especially want to thank Dilip Mahaske ji. So he worked hard, he worked very hard. So Krishna Ji, give him a big hand please. And I welcome Professor Kishale, Helen Kaurati Kaushal Parvati. And I also welcome, ek baar khade hokar please welcome kariye, Sri Mrs. Reema Gangwali Lal Ji. Thank you for coming. एक बार इनको गिव द बिग हैंड ऑफ अप्लॉज प्लीज. और ये हमारे जो मैम है शी सो काइंड कि सेकंड टाइम हम यहां पर मना रहे हैं. और मैं एक बात आपको बता दूं कि श्री गुरुदास टेंपल ऑफ न्यूयॉर्क यहां पे इन्होंने बाबा साहब की जो फोटो वहां पर लगाई थी. सो एक बार फिर प्लीज गिव द बिग हैंड ऑफ अप्लॉज बिकॉज़ दे ऑलवेज सैल्यूट यू फॉर दैट इवेंट. थैंक यू सो मच. और आई वेलकम आल्सो प्रोफेसर कौशल पांगर न्यू दिल्ली. आई आल्सो उनके लिए सभी के लिए ताली बजाइए. मिस हेलन कर अंबेडकर इन यूक्रेन. सो वी आर गोइंग बियॉन्ड द लिमिट्स नाउ. हेलन कर मिस जिल कैली वाशिंगटन डीसी अंबेडकर एंड वुमेन एम्पावरमेंट शी इज वर्किंग ऑन दैट. Ms. Prachya Bakaria ji, Dalit activist in New York, Washington DC. Prachya ji,
मुझे तो कहीं पे खाओ.
And Chanchal Mal from Canada, she is also working a lot in India and in Rockford. So I welcome you all. So this is going to be, and I also welcome and also thanks for Devi Prakash Party of New York, President, Special President, Parishila. Indrapali and all the people in Gangapura and Shibashi Shibur Das Temple of New York, President Ashok Kumari ji, Sanjeev Chauhan is here, ma'am. I thank you all. They are coming on the way. I'm so sorry, ma'am. So they are on the way. They are coming over here. More than 100 people over here, I'm sure. Because of Punjabi is little always late. So thank you so much. I don't want to stay with you and ma'am. Kamboli Das ji, so I will request her to come over here. And one thing more important, Akanksha ma'am, give her the big hand of applause. She is going to handle all the program today. So I welcome Mrs. Reema Kamboli Das ji, jo ke CG in New York, isi office mein. So inka thank you, inke saare staff ka thank you, jo aaj aaye ho, specially is program ko kar rahe hai. So I will invite Akanksha ma'am ji, inke liye give a big hand. So, she is having a stage today and she is a young energetic girl. She is also teaching in Colombia where Baba sir already study over here. So she has a more opportunity like to follow Baba sir. So thank you so much. So you can get it now. Thank you. Thank you.
Hi everyone, my name is Akanksha Anand. I'm doing a PhD in social policy at Fordham University. And why I stand here today is because I am a product of policy. I've come from a background of Dalit. And why this cause is important to me is because my dad runs a college for disempowered women in India. And this is a very passionate cause for me to come here today. And I want to welcome you all. So thank you for joining us today at this 126th birth anniversary of policy. Thank you for your presence. I don't know what you all have to do to just get here there, and I'm sorry to start late. So without further ado, I would like to call the Council General of India here. This is Lady Bagamji Das. Please have a seat.
Good afternoon and a very warm welcome to all of you to the Indian Consulate, especially our guests from abroad. I dear guests from London, Ukraine, Canada, and from India. A very warm welcome to all of you. This is India House, though it's called New India House because there is another India House in the square. This is India House, this is your house, and I'm really very pleased that this is the second year that we are doing this event to commemorate the birth anniversary of Dr. Ambedkar. You'll hear a lot about Dr. Ambedkar today during the course of this event. For me as a woman, I think it's very important the role he played in terms of, you know, drafting a constitution, drafting the Hindu Board Bill. That I think is very important. The vision that he had of a society where women get equal position. Today, if Indian women enjoy certain rights, it is absolutely because of the vision of this man who was able to resist a lot of pressure which was put on him. I think from all sections of the society, there was resistance to the to the laws that he was proposing. The opposition to caste system is something which is fundamental to the Indian constitution, to the Indian system. But the contribution that he has made during 1949 to 50 as the law minister of the government of India to protect the rights of Indian women is something I want to talk a little bit about. While Dr. Ambedkar was busy visualizing the Indian constitution, he also relentlessly fought against the orthodoxy in our society to advocate reforms in Hindu personal law so as to give equal and greater rights to women in India. If today Indian women have social, political and economic empowerment, we must owe much of that to the great vision of Dr. Ambedkar. Dr. Ambedkar's efforts to reform outdated social practices and orthodoxy of the then society was met with tremendous resistance from all sections of society. It generated strong sentiments, but Dr. Ambedkar was steadfast in his determination. Through his visionary approach, he brought about reforms in India that had given us the right to marry outside, that had given Hindu women the right to marry outside their caste, divorce of the husband, inherit property, and various other rights which had been denied to them because of social practices of that time. It was his determination that he pushed through the Hindu Board Bill, and between the two, as his leadership as the law minister and as the draft, one of the principal figures in drafting the constitution, I mean, the foundation of a modern India, the foundation of a contemporary modern society was laid by the vision of Dr. Ambedkar.
स्पीकर में आगे
आगे स्पीकर आना ठीक द भीम ऐप व्हिच हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड इन इंडिया आई नो मेनी ऑफ यू मस्ट हैव फॉलोड द लॉन्च एंड देयर इज एन इवेंट इन यूएन आल्सो ऑन डिजिटल पेमेंट सो एम्पावरमेंट हिज विजन ऑफ एम्पावरमेंट एंड मैसेज ऑफ एम्पावरमेंट इज बीइंग इंप्लीमेंटेड इवन टिल टुडे एंड सो आई एम डिलाइटेड दैट वी आर डूइंग दिस इवेंट विद ऑल ऑफ यू this afternoon. I hope we do it again for years to come. And once again, a very warm welcome to all of you, especially our guests from abroad. Wish you a very happy, today is also celebrated as the New Year all over India, from Vaishakhi to Vishu to Poila Vaishakh to Bihu. It's a great occasion. So wish you all the best and have a very pleasant afternoon. Thank you.
Thank you, Council General, for emphasizing the importance of his stand for India and for really making a difference for women in this world. He really took that on. So thank you for re-emphasizing that and restoring his presence and power in our world. Thank you. They were great words of speech. Thanks. Next, I'd like to call on stage. Next, I'd like to call on stage Professor Kaushal Panwar from Delhi University, who has relentlessly worked on the issues of caste and untouchability and talks about women empowerment and empowering people in the world around caste and issues of gender. So without further much ado, please give her a round of applause. She's come a long way from India.
Thank you so much.
Jai Bhim. You can say me. Jai Bhim. First of all, I would like to say thank you of Dalit Maski and for inviting me here. Today I will talk empowering the people through digital technology for social and financial inclusion. Before start my talk, I would like to say thank you to all of you for listening to me and forgive me if I deliver anything you did not tell about my talk. The social media which is influencing our life is a big way. Is generally dominated by the elite section of the society. The opinion being formulated on social media is generally benefit of any through the decision on the issues. There is an adapter to create a kind of diaspora and serious discussion don't take place. Digitization has led to greater divided in the society as access to technology is generally available to urban, middle class, English educated people. They are getting the new jobs which have come up. How many Dalits, marginalized people got job in software industry and the BPO sector? Unsurprisingly, the new number is actually in the society by a commentary in the national media was that of dismissal. At the heart of the decision of reservation are at least two broad arguments. The first argument is that reservation are at least two broad arguments. First argument is that individual freedoms and rights are calculated woman is skilled meritorious candidates is overlooked for this someone who is selected merely on the basis of an identity that he or she did not meritorious acquire. The second argument is that private sector values skill, efficiency and enterprising irrespective of dynamism such as caste, and this implies that there is a little scope for caste-based discrimination in these sectors. While the first argument has been debated at the length in our media, the second argument has not any or enough relevant discussion. Even though it should ideally be the starting point of any discourse on reservation and other affirmative action. Not many would argue there is no caste-based discrimination in the rural India, or that there was no such discrimination historical in India. The fact is that certain castes, such as Dalits, have been socially excluded from the full participation in the Indian society and economically over the past few centuries. There is documented evidence that in the India's place, Dalits continue to be denied equal access to public and private goods such as water, bodies, roads, land ownership, market, financial institutions, and the work and the jobs. As a result, the members belonging to such caste exist poor social sanctions. Indicators such as higher rate of poverty, lower literacy rate, and higher infant mortality. However, that is rural India. What about the modern urban India? A casual glance at the metropolitan section in our Sunday newspaper shows that caste plays a major role in our social space, but there is active discrimination in the modern private sector economy. Since profit and efficiency are the guiding principle in a market economy, the claim is that only the most efficient workers are employed, leaving no room for indiscrimination in the basis of the caste and other identities. For instance, in 2007, Economist magazine claimed that there is no strong evidence that companies discriminate against the low-caste job application. However, such articles misses the research which does not show the Dalits and other backward class caste are in fact discriminated against even in the modern private sector. One of more telling studies on such discrimination was conducted by Economist Professor Shukdev Tharat and K.S. Niman, his colleague, in 2005 or 6. They used the recommendations control trial, RCT, method to explore how the job application by highly educated Indians from various caste backgrounds are received by the modern urban private sector, including the prominent Indian and multinational companies. The scholar collected the advertisement for job opening from the several national and regional newspapers, including the Times of India, Hindustan Times, The Hindu, Deccan Chronology, and others. They chose only those opening which recent graduate would be eligible for in the sector, such as IT,
pharma, finance, accounting, automobiles, mass media, construction, banking, and other university like JNU and Delhi University. These advertisements were then responded by submitting fake resume which had immediate educational qualification and work experience. The resume were all strong enough to be considered for the hiring. The only thing that worried in these resume was the same sum had so-called higher caste sounding name like Mishra, Bhartwaj, Sharma, etc. and such with distinctly Dalit name as described by the researcher like Chauhan, Pawar or anything else. In all, 4,808 applications were made for 548 job advertisement. The results were that an application with a Dalit name had only a 87 chance of being called for the second round as compared by the applicant of any equal qualified education people, so-called Hindu. The same study was revealed by the Muslim name application had only 33.5